Let's get ready to rumble!
It's like this fast-acting medical moisturizer, just hearing about the suffering of writers and their creative process. But some people just go so far they become almost like this mythological creature. Like this author here, Hob Brune, who I thought would be interesting to take a look at because his particular tragedy struck midway through his career. In fact, while he was writing this work here itself, which I always thought made reference to his medical apparatus, the tube through which he created this text, but really it's more in regards to the gray mirrors that surrounded him as he was growing up. He was born in 1950. His parents were both entertainers. In fact, his father was a celebrity of sorts.
Heywood Hale Brune and his wife, Jane.
Main character receives a deferment from the draft because his father, curiously named Gordo, had pulled some strings, and he ended up working at CBS in this underground bunker-like facility, reviewing stories as they came out of the teletype machine. Sort of like this proto-overload of social media that this guy was going through. I don't know if it was a cause or effect of his own frenetic gaze. You get the sense that the scenes were chosen to be written out just from the texture of the language as it's getting birthed out of that creative orifice. It's sort of like a sphincter that doesn't have any control, and it's just like this long this magazine. Egress is the first issue. Great magazine. And they did a remembrance of Hob Brune where friends and folks had just written about him. There's sort of like this voyeuristic basket case transformation porn thing going on here where I wanted to see if his altered state was detectable in the text itself. Some surgery was planned, and when they opened him up, the surgeon had discovered some tumors along his spine and thought he would be a hero and remove them. But when the author came to, he was paralyzed from the neck down, and from then on, he had to rely on a respirator in order to breathe and live. The body, we know, is like this impingement on writing, and it's where you try to derange it with drugs or a dream state that sometimes something powerful arises. But what if the body is completely dispensed with from the neck down and you just have a ghost body